Hello, Nana here. Gonna run 4 tier 2 blue maps in a row just to have them unlocked. Nope, we'll just see if they get exciting or not. Monsters deal extra fire damage and poison damage, so they're gonna hurt a little. But we'll see. Yes. Okay, one desert. So enemies are gonna hurt more than they usually do. The fast increase in fire damage of course means I'll be taking much more damage. And damage that I can't simply shrug off with my armor. Oh, hello there, beastie. Blood Geyser. And I has it. Not desperate access, but a little too large. This is a good start, though. Oh, very first trial. So I guess this one just got promoted to an actual YouTube video, rather than not something that was intended as just a. In between, oh, let's just clear some of the low level stuff so we can move on with the higher level stuff. Kind of thing. I mean, it's also why I still record it and I still end up talking. Because otherwise, of course, it would have been a bit of waste. Okay, just clearing all the beasties in the nearby neighborhood. Well, just so I have a more or less clear place to go after I'm done here, which is over there. And as you can see, this is indeed the first one. Oh, Zodiac Ladder. You know what? Let's just empty pockets here. Or empty pockets, rather. Okay. There's always plenty of portals. Trial of Burning Rage. So obviously there's gonna be floor lava. I've got a regen on my side, which is nice. Definitely makes it easier to deal with this sort of stuff. Maybe I shouldn't be standing inside of the lava while I clear out the regular mobs, but I'm just trying to get rid of the minions. Okay, so time to crank. And a time to crank that opens up the door, and once open it stays open. But I heard currency drop. I couldn't see it, but I heard it. And I wouldn't be surprised if it were on the other side. Well, it didn't say that it was special currency, so I guess it's all right to maybe miss one blacksmith's whetstone or something. Lever. That opens up this one, then this one leads to bleeding. Okay, another one. Ah, oh, it's so nice having a boat out of regen. Really makes this easier to do. It's not effortless, but definitely easier than when you're, let's say, an energy shield built without any regen. This is difficult that way. Okay, another one. Lost my golem somewhere along the way. The trap here, I think this is the, see damage taken while you use movement skills. Damage is rather minimal, so you can shrug it off. Also, if you, I think it only counts if you use the movement skills while you're standing inside of the circle. So if you only pass through from the outside and don't land inside of the circle, you ought to be fine. But as I say, got enough regen that it's difficult to double check that that is indeed the case. Okay, last section I suspect. So there's a timed crank over there, there's a timed crank over here. Ah, flame. Oh. Get out of my face. I think I was too slow, otherwise that one would likely have opened up. But oh, I did get held up. So let's try this again. Yeah, see? That usually means the door opens. Okay, so indeed we got fire over here. Okay, so somewhere else fire has been opened. So probably gotta repeat it for, I think it was thunder? Yeah, we got thunder and then this is gonna be ice. Yeah. Also, way forward is probably here, so let's do ice next. Okay, taking a little more damage than I had wanted. Also, I missed a crank at the start. That's inconvenient. Oh, still counts. Well, if you open them in reverse order, it should be the same as opening in the normal order. And look at that, flask recharges. And that's a dwarf cult. Hey, and the last one. Thunder, that's a door. Okay, lever one. Lever two. No time levers here. Well, I suspect because they're not timed, they were probably locked behind the other ones. And then we have a lever and then actually everything opens. And there is the exit. So let's just deal with all these monsters. And then the last one. And I am free!
Allow your wisdom to be tempered by the flames of the past.
Yes. Wisdom, flames of the past, tempering. Okay, let's continue looking for the boss. So I wonder how many maps I'll have to run to find all six different trials. Basically, no, am I gonna be lucky or am I gonna be unlucky here? Because it really, really varies just how many maps you'll have to run. My worst record so far in a single league is having to do 23 trials before finding the sixth very different trial. Hope it's gonna be less. But no, there have also been many leagues where the league ended before I even got to that point. So I guess I could call myself lucky then. So what's in the box? Increased rarity. Just shoot at it from the side here. Net. And all I get is a portal. Yeah, that's not what you would call a good investment. Though, it's more of a gamble. That's maybe a better way of looking at it. It's not an investment, it's a gamble. If you gamble, assume you've lost everything, and maybe there's an upside. Conversely, of course, with gambling, if you can't afford to lose what you're gambling, don't bet it. But no, one orb of transmutation seems like a small effort. Small stakes. So kind of funny, I'm not really noticing too much of the extra damage, but that's of course because most of the enemies don't really get a chance to shoot at me. Oh, hello. Chance orb. That's still decent. Looks like that is a way forward, and this is probably a side area. Exactly. And another dead end. Wonderful. 50 plus mobs remaining. It felt like I would probably be close to the boss already, but I guess there's still more to be explored. This map often turns out to be larger than I expected to be, or anticipated to be. Okay. So, if I remember correctly at least, this is one of those maps that actually does have the boss out in the open. And it's one of those self-replicating archer bosses. Oh, similar to Nightwing. Okay, anyway, 16%. Yes, cold and lightning. I mean, the 16% ones are the best rings you could get in terms of resistance efficiency. And I just mercilessly cut down two rare beasties. Yes, autopiloting a little too much here. And he kind of jumped to his own doom. Oh no, truth be told, I do have a lot of beasties already. And I don't really find myself crafting all that many things anymore. The rare recipes are very nice while leveling. But for endgame crafting, the result is often just too rubbish to really be worth the effort. And in terms of uniques, I'm still looking for a belt, but I just don't get the right monsters to sacrifice for that. For my summoner, I would like the chance to craft some high-level staves. I would like to get a Femurs of the Saints. Okay, there was a yellow in there somewhere. I think I murdered it. Oh, wait, this is different. This is actually the... Just. Okay, might as well just clear out all the add-ons here. And one monster remains. You. Haha. Pretty eye pecker. Sure. Got this thing with spikes flying all over the place. It is surprisingly effective for dealing with bosses that get you ambushed from all sides. Ooh, rare courthouse. I like it. And then we get spawns long after the boss is already dead. Which is kind of funny. But they drop maps, so I'm not complaining. Right, and these sand gliders, they shoot at you from a distance, so either you shoot back or you have to make a circuit. And no more monsters remain. Wonderful. That was a full clear. Also, unique. A relentless fury. Let's see. Calling strike. Onslaught for 3 seconds on calling strike. Cannot be chilled while you have onslaught. And a bit of leech on it. It's not a bad starter weapon. Then, of course, you go into the maps, you go into the maps. Offering to the goddess goes into the fragments, and you are a unique. So, into the unique bin you go, the level appropriate one. This was a potential crafting base, so into the bin for stuff to deal with later. And then the other things can get sold. Let's see, was this useful? Bit of resists, it's not too many. It's 55, bit of life, bit of strength, bit of dex. And the other mods are wasted. Yeah, so this one is just trash. Okay, so next map. So, flooded mines. Oh, unidentified, that is nice. Did I have an unidentified hair already? Oh, also, let's stock up on some Make prophecies. A single tap. Unbreathing Queen, already had it. Oh, bit of guide. Enhance the quality of a map with a single chisel. Okay. Dreamer's Dream. So that's kill the boss, get a rare map. It's gonna be a random map. Powerful invader. Oh, I like it. So one chisel. Can I chisel unidentified ones? I wonder. I can. A single tap nice. So that's no 20% on top of the 30% that you get for running it unidentified. I like it. And then one more prophecy. God of misfortune. Kuduku and Kadaka. That's going back to where Kuduku spawns in the ledge. Flooded Mines. The new name of what was previously known as the Caverns. It's still the same map, as far as I can tell. With the same golem as boss. Okay, 17% pack size, nearly 98% commodity, 26 rarity. No auras. Resists are still good. Life regen still looks same. Block still looks same. Armor still looks same. Okay, enemies seem to be getting charges. Charges on hit, okay. That's fine. That's perfectly fine. I still have regen. So I don't really care. 17%, that's always decent. Corrupting blood. Could that be that I've got Nemesis on here? No. Otherwise this one would have had a Nemesis mod as well. But it's just a chance occurrence. So this map is roughly round / square in shape. You make a big circuit. There's a path among the outside, there's small passages on the inside and some small rooms on the inside, though they don't always connect back to the outside. So whenever you see something branching off to the center, that is useful to actually follow, since most of the time it is a dead end. And no, therefore it's just natural to pick them up as you go rather than ignoring them for later, since backtracking is more annoying. Okay, I accidentally clicked that, I shouldn't have. Okay. So the boss is going to be roughly on the opposite of where I started. Also, they again accidentally killed a rare. I'm getting rather good at that, but increased damage output. And of course no warning of the regular mobs. But I think at this point, that's just something I'll have to accept. So I just deal a lot of damage. 20,000 DPS listed right now. Over 21,000 DPS. And that's just no tooltip. Real damage actually gets higher than that. Because I've got a bonus damage for dealing damage to bleeding enemies. If enemies are maimed, I deal extra damage. I'll deal extra damage while I'm leeching, though doesn't occur all that often. Though, yeah, I keep bouncing between leeching and not leeching. Never quite at full life because of blood magic. Okay. I mean, this is what I mean with those small corridors. They always get you back, or they're always dead ends. Well, almost. Via the center, sometimes there are paths that actually link sections of the outside together. In those cases, it's useful to backtrack. But not until you've actually confirmed that that is indeed the case. Good for the loot this. Well, every once in a while an item that drops is actually an improvement, so nope. It is worth doing. I mean, for example, found this one. 2000 armor, double resists. There's no life on here, but the other mods are pretty good, so it is tempting. Of course, this one has 93.2 life, so that is also very, very good. And for the time being, it looks like I don't need the life, but... Or I don't need the increase in armor. That's useful, but I don't need it. Not with, though, usually 7 endurance charges up. Okay, roughly across from where I started. Hey, Oregon Gate. Reason I mention I'm roughly across from where I started is because the boss has a habit of spawning roughly across from where you start. Which is useful. Oh, useful to know and prepare for. Yeah, there it is, the eroding one. So I'll just take out the add-ons first. Wyvern bow, that's better than that's. Oh, another add-on. And down you go. Hey, Axiom Perpetuum. Okay, let's just check out a couple of other things. Nice starter scepter, especially if you're using spells with good damage efficiency. Check that one out. Cool. And then we'll just grab some smaller items. Oh, like that. I said like that. And then empty pockets. And then we're gonna hunt after the yellow that spawned on the map. The yellow beastie, that is. Okay, also overflowing a little bit in scrolls. I'll need them to identify all the rares I picked up, but for the time being, let's just reduce the size of the pile. And go hunting for yellow legendary beasts. Chicken demon. Okay, they are much sturdier than regular ones, but this one has extra life that helps. Netting. Chucking, grabbing. 69 area, I'm level 7, or my nets go until 70, so that still works. Boots, buckler, other things are once again too large. Wait, you're not a beastie. So I can just kill you without any problems. It's always funny that the shriekers, they don't count as beasts. Even though they're clearly bird-like. Wave slice, I'll actually capture you. I thought about it, yay. Well, yeah, yellow legendaries, they are not. Yeah, so the way forward, I suspect, goes this way. There's a chicken demon here, yellow chicken demon. Rare, just a regular rare chicken demon, not a yellow legendary. Damn, that's confusing with those colors. Okay, but there's a small room on the inside here that I do wanna clear. Okay. Statue demon. Or one of those hammer throw things. Oh, look at that. Another net. But no, in terms of early mapping, no, this progress here is pretty good. Power level is pretty good. So. We did a tier 6 map earlier, so yep, that's alright, or tier 6 Zana map, that went alright. So now I'm just trying to catch up to that. Hello, shriekers. Okay, a little bit. Question here is, what's the way forward? I think this might be a dead end. Actually, it seems like it might be a split one. Sneaky game. Oh, another chicken demon. I as you.
You have been captured, beast.
Or a rooster fiend. Nearly a chicken. Hello there. Goodbye there. Ooh, Zana. That is an unexpected bonus. So previous map we got a trial, here we got a Zana.
Still sane,
I'm most definitely not complaining about this. So it feels like I did mostly a full clear. Oh, seriously, that one nearly got away. Just a sliver of health. Okay, 10 monsters survive. There's no obvious place I think I missed. So just no stray monster here, stray monster there, stray monster everywhere. It's empty pockets, and then we go into the Zana mission. Let's see, tier 2. Okay. Let's see, what is Zana offering? Okay, Untainted Paradise. Nice, that's a Zana only unique map. And the bonus of that is that it only contains beasts. So that is very, very relevant. And the unique bosses are also beasts, and they are part of the bestiary that you need to collect. So yeah, I'll probably end up spending quite some of my nets on this one. So this is good. Let's do this. Another upside of Untainted Paradise. It has massively increased experience. But you don't get any items from this, so... That's nice. That's very, very, very nice. Okay, Fossil Eaters. I don't have you yet, so... Now I do. Gonna take this one relatively... slow, just to... make sure I catch all the different beast types. Since this is a random spawn, there's no real way to deterministically get it. So I just want to extract every beastie from this I can. So there's some blues here, and I also spotted a yellow bit to the right. Just a regular rare. This nice. Yeah, there. Okay, netting. There we go. It's a level 70, so the simple steel nets, they do work here. Wild Camaro, yo. Have you? Oh, Primal Beast. Have you?
You are captured, stupid beast.
Actually, you're lying to me, mister. These primals are not getting captured, so that means my bear storage is full. So I'll need to capture at least a yellow bear in order to pump something else out. I wish you would at least just get capture credit for it. This is slightly annoying. And yeah, see, you can't actually go to the menagerie from here to purge it, so you're kind of stuck that way. Now, small lacks of quality of life, things like that, are a little on the annoying side, but well, if that's all there's to it. No, those are things that are fixable. Question is, of course, are the devs gonna bother fixing it? Since community perception of this leak has been pretty bad. I mean, a minority of folks seem to like it.
You are captured.
Ooh, yellow. Yellow, that is. Legendary yellow. Okay, yeah, nice, it's a bear. That's good. Okay. Okay, killing all the add-ons. Cave spine. Stacking some bleed on you. And then throwing my net. And I have you. Nice. So that turned out well, because now I do have primal beasts. So wild chimerals, already have them. And there were no yellows lurking in here. Okay, some blues. But yeah, the community perception of this leak has been more negative than anything that came before. And I suspect... No, it's not really due to the leak itself being bad, but it's just that... It feels more like a core mechanic rather than a leak. Oh. Let's upgrade that. I missed the yellow, but already had it, so that's okay. Because no, most of the mods so far, or most of the leaks so far, they added a boatload of additional mobs and item drops while you were playing. Whereas here, oh, every once in a while there's this yellow or red legendary beastie, and that's kind of it. Let's see. Ooh, small life bonus. And that pushes me over 4,000. Nice. But no, this leak, it's yeah, outside of those couple of extra rare mobs, there's nothing. So in terms of loot drops, you just get less. And that's no, while leveling in maps, it's kind of the same. It's like it's a core mechanic already and there's no leak going on. So if you're really cynical about it and you don't really care about the Pokemon minigame that's in here, then you might as well be playing standard. Oh, this is standard with small upsides, basically. So, oh, understandably, people are like, oh, where's my leak? But I suspect that the feedback there about Bestiary as a core mechanic and it as a leak, I hope the devs are able to make the distinction between them. Okay. That chieftain I want to capture, yes. And that bear as well, good. I mean, in the past I've captured plenty of white and blue bears, so no, getting those out and replaced with yellows is going to be helpful. So expect to be running into devourers soonish. But yeah, I mean, if the devs, why I'm talking about all of this, of course, if the perception of the league is not all that great, then devs might have figured that they're not really gonna put this in as a core mechanic. You have been captured, beast. In which case, there's no sense in adding more quality of life features to it, which is what I fear might be happening. Since now in the first week or two we got some small updates, and after that it's been pretty silent on the update front. I think we have maybe, if we're lucky, a single dev doing some updates, but it doesn't really feel like now they're actively working on just ironing out all the issues and quality of life things. No, they've had too much time and did too little in that regard. So, yeah, I really wonder if this is gonna be core mechanic. Because I also think that the devs might actually be able to make the distinction between, okay, this is a core mechanic and this is as a leak, and filtering out the feedback and people complaining about things, saying what they're complaining about might not always be the root causes what they're complaining about, so devs, they should dig deeper on that. Let's see, Spectral Shield throw goes up. Nice, little upgrade. But of course then, if they do decide to add it to the game, then it might be that a lot of the players are not able to make that distinction. And they might rage about it anyway. Oh, hello, see, there's the devourers. So these are ancient devourers.
You have been captured, beast.
Have you?
Survivor, or you will be fooled.
Would be lovely to get some slightly higher tier ones. But at least getting one means I can check it off the list, which is good. So yeah, the future of Bestiary in my opinion is uncertain. Definitely seem to have put a lot of effort into it. I'm actually just gonna kill this one. Wanna keep some of my nets for the bosses here. Oh, hello. Silvercrush, you are gonna be mine.
This one is captured. I now will take it.
But yeah, a lot of effort went into this leak. But it also feels like the effort did not go in the direction that it should have. I mean, building that entire menagerie. Well, from a looks point of view, sure. No, they put a lot of effort into it, but maybe, in terms of total effort, it might have been better if the devs simply, you know, had like a couple cages around and put in some token effort for the looks, and just focus more on actual behaviors. Let's see, capture another one of you. Don't really have too many devourers. No, there were little monkeys. I still need to capture one of those. They keep getting away. Oh. Okay. Captured a little monkey. Because I don't think anyone really cares about the looks of the menagerie. With all respect to the devs that made it, but no, who cares? I mean, I would be surprised if a significant portion of the player base cares about the menagerie and actually goes there and looks at the beasties. I would be really surprised if people do. I think most of the time people are much more mechanically inclined than that. Okay, getting some odd lag spikes here. Whoa, okay. So that was the silence before the storm of a bunch of devourers trying to devour me. Well, trying, didn't succeed. Okay, I think I got all the little ones happily tucked away. But yeah, no, I just hope that some part of the bestiary is going to stay around. The blood crafting, especially the some of the leveling items, flask crafting, crafting random uniques, for linking. Those are very, very useful recipes, especially while leveling. I mean, once you hit maps, don't really care too much. I mean, then that's usually the point where you have enough fuses to, no, don't have to think about forelinking something anymore. Okay, 8 monsters remaining. I think there's 6 or 7 bosses, so there might be 1 or 2 mobs remaining. But generally, got it done. Okay, so 4 traps here, meaning I will have to switch to the next tier inside. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, there's 6 different ones. I just have to be very, very careful. That's the most important part. Okay, the first net. But they are not beasties. Why are they not beasties? Seriously. Game. Okay. Game, I think we need to have a good conversation about what is a beastie and what is not. These are clearly beasties. Okay. Oh, that's a shame. Let's have a... Wait, I don't think there were felines, but for the primates. Konu, Shuk, those are... vowel bosses. Echo of the Verdant, that is part of a prophecy line in the Southern Forest. Spirit of Aiden and Nadia. I think they might be Apostles? Not entirely sure. Aiden and Nadia are, of course, from the Hollow. The Dread Thicket, that one. Nearly the same. Okay, on the Ursai side. Okay, so I think I was confusing Primal Beasts, which are just the ones that walk around, with the boss versions of those. Oh, still too bad. It would have been nice having to capture these specific uniques as part of the the bestiary challenge. But I did manage to clear this. I already cleared the outer map, so we can go back to the hideout, and then I think this is a good point to call it. So managed to get two maps done, Flooded Mines and the desert, which after the fact actually became Shaper Touched. But for now, I'm ignoring that. I still have a couple more tier 2s to do before all of them have been unlocked. I really like the glowy bar underneath to see what you have and have not yet cleared. Definitely makes it more convenient to just check what you want slash need to run from right here. Extra quality of life improvement would of course be if also there was a highlight on the map itself, because then you could actually go to Zana and buy only the maps that you still need, rather than having to walk up and down to download. No, those are quality of life things. Eventually they will come, but oftentimes you have to be patient and wait for it just a little while longer. For now though, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching, and hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.